So you've also got to take that into consideration when using the tech. Did you really just poop on us? Really? Thank you, Rex. World. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It is CJ, the Cheese DJ here, and we're back with another Arc Insight video. And as you can probably tell, today we're going to be taking a look at the Tech Sword versus the Primitive Sword. So today we're going to compare its stats against the Primitive Sword and just exactly what it does. Now you can see at the moment we've got it equipped and you can't actually swing it. You can't do anything with the Tech Sword at the moment. Can't chop trees, can't attack dinosaurs, can't do nothing with it. Now, due to the fact that it has no element within it, it's practically useless. You can't do anything without element in it. Now, if we pull this bad boy out, that's what it looks like with element in it. It looks very cool. It looks like a popsicle stick that you could probably eat, although I wouldn't recommend eating it. So you can see there, it lights up and everything, and now you're actually able to attack with it. So before we get further into the video and compare everything else with it, we're gonna just let you guys know just how much element you use per swing. So one regular swing without actually hitting anything uses up 0.5 of element. If you look down in the bottom left-ish kind of corner, you can see we're at 98%. If I swing twice, it'll drop down to 97. Now, if you come up against a structure such as a tree, which you can indefinitely kill and knock down with one blow, it also does 1% of element used up. Now, the same goes for stone, whereas it only uses 0.5. You can see we're still on 96%, and we've now dropped to 95. Now, if we come up to, say, this is probably going to end terribly for us. If you come up to a dinosaur, for example, and attack a dinosaur, that uses up 2% of the element you have stored. Now, a really frustrating thing about the Tech Sword is that you can't actually harvest the corpse of dinos. However, you do waste element while using it. So it's really frustrating that you can't actually harvest corpses of the dinos that you kill. But you can destroy the stone and tree structures that are located around on the island. So the Tech Sword also has a charge up attack. You can see there, we look like we're about to take a really big poo. but you can see we've got a little reticle that comes up, and this uses up 3% of the element that you have stored in the actual Tech Sword. So in terms of tech wise and using it for element, it's not too bad because you know you are able to farm element quite easily from some of the easier broodmother bosses. So it's not too difficult to get enough element. However, you still want to be cautious with how much you run around just swinging it like a crazy psychopath. Now, you can also use the Tech Sword underwater. You can see we're getting demolished by a bunch of piranhas. You can use it underwater, and you see that we're damaging them. However, the only thing you can't actually do with the Tech Sword underwater is use your secondary charge-up attack, which you saw earlier in the video. That is the only thing you can't really do underwater with the Tech Sword. You can see here, we're still trying to use it, but no, it doesn't seem to want to work underwater, which kind of makes sense. You've got really no way to propel yourself forward under the water, I guess, but you can still destroy the rocks underwater as well. Alrighty, so now we're going to get into the damage side of things. Now, you saw previously we did 258 damage to a dinosaur. That's actually incorrect for us. Due to us having 125 melee damage, our melee damage on the Tech Sword is boosted by 25%, so the actual base damage of the Tech Sword is 200. So if we come in and split screen this up, I'll demonstrate to you the amount of damage it does. Now, if you look to the bottom screen, you'll see here we're actually dealing 200 damage, and that is the amount of damage you do to other players with a base melee damage of 100. So you've got that as well to take into consideration. The more you level up your melee damage, the more damage you will. Okay, wow, look at the top screen, you can see the floating sword, it's quite a magical thing. Thundercats unite! Alrighty. So a regular primitive sword on another player with a base melee damage of 100 only deals 90 damage. So there's a 110 point difference in between the Tech Sword and the primitive sword when it comes to players. So if we come up to dinosaurs, for example, the damage is still the same, doing a base damage of 200 with a base melee damage of 100. Now, the primitive sword as well only deals 72 to dinos, so there's a slight difference in between the amount of damage the primitive sword does to players against dinos. Now, if we come into the charge attack, the damage against players is 280 plus 65 extra damage as a base damage. And against dinosaurs, the 65 damage is reduced slightly to 52 damage. So you've also got to take that into consideration when using the test. Did you really just poop on us? Really? Thank you, Rex. I did also forget to mention, guys, that with the Tech Sword, the charge attack, you can actually use it in any direction. So you can actually launch yourself straight up into the sky. So if there's a pesky fly trying to fly over you and do bombing runs on you, just charge up your Tech Sword and launch straight into him into the sky. Alrighty, so next up we took a look at the crafting cost of the Tech Sword, and whew, you'd be surprised at how much it costs. So all up, it costs 180 polymer, 675 metal ingots, 180 crystal, 40 element, and 80 black pearls. Now on top of that, you've got to also take into consideration that you need the tech replicator as well to be able to craft this, whereas the metal primitive sword only requires 50 metal ingots, 1 wood, and 15 hide. So there's a huge difference in terms of resource cost in between the two swords for a difference in practically 110 damage plus the cool looking sword and charge attack. So what we decided to do then, since the damage between the primitive sword and the tech sword wasn't too much, you're looking at 110 points of damage. We then decided to spawn in a couple more different sword levels at different damages. You can see here we've got a few mastercrafts, we've got an apprentice currently in our inventory, and we're gonna just see how much damage those guys do against the wild dinos of the land. So you saw there 102 damage on the Fiomia, so we did an extra bonus 10 damage in comparison to the regular primitive sword. Now you're probably wondering why I've gotten rid of split screen. Well, I've mind wiped and we now have only 100 melee damage, so we're now able to accurately use our own character to show you guys the damage slots. So we then decided to use a mastercraft sword. Now this sword has a base melee damage of 197. And this raptor has so voluntarily run up to us and decided to be our test dummy. So you saw there we were doing 141 damage with the primitive sword on mastercraft level, which, you know, isn't too bad of a trade-off. You're only losing about 60 points of damage in comparison to, say, a huge resource cost to craft the tech sword. And all you lose really is the charge attack and the cool kind of looking sword. Now, if we buff that damage up by, say, 20% and come up to, what have we got over here? We've got a Therizinosaurus and a Fiomia. Probably gonna go with the Fiomia, just we kind of value our life at the moment. So this one still kind of does the same amount of damage. Oh, sorry, helps if we actually swap the swords. So we come up to the Fiomia, we can see that 157. So if you're able to get yourself a hands on a Mastercraft sword, for example, you'll easily be able to take out, now we're in trouble. You'll easily be able to take out, you know, and deal the same amount of damage that a tech sword is able to do. So you don't really need to worry about crafting up a tech sword if you have access to an ascendant primitive sword blueprint. So make sure you take that into consideration when you decide whether or not you want to craft the tech sword. So what we're gonna do here now is we're just gonna quickly spawn in an ascendant sword. Now you'll see here, there we go. All right, now this should give us an ascendant. Yeah, there we go. Now, if we come into the Ascendant, here we go, damage 250. I don't see there being too much of a difference between the Ascendant and the Mastercraft. If we come here, okay, I can't see, 180. So you're only 20 points off the amount of damage you would do with a Tech Sword. So it's, I don't know if it's really worth that much, the Tech Sword. I think it's much better to get yourself hands on an Ascendant blueprint for a Primitive Sword and just use that, guys, because the Tech Sword, I don't think it's really worth all that for the 200 points of damage and the charge attack. I mean, you can craft yourself up the tech sword if you really desire and, you know, only use it in situations of dire need, but there's really no need for it. Alrighty, guys, that'll be it for today. Thanks very much for watching, and hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, but other than that, guys, catch you in the next one.